10, we share an incredible survival story. Hazel Rose faced the longest of odds when she was born, but her fight far outweighed her tiny size. 13's Melissa Bruner shares the family's long journey home.
All babies' homecomings are joyous.
Easy girl.
But this one was a long time in coming.
Every time I look at her, I'm just like, I can't believe you're here.
Hazel Rose started life like this.
She was 24 weeks and 13 ounces.
Parents Nikki and Corey Kusick say the pregnancy was fairly normal until 23 weeks when Nikki's blood pressure soared. She was hospitalized with preeclampsia.
My OB, Dr. Blake, kind of kept just saying, you know, if you can hold on one more day, like, you'll give her a better shot. We held on for 8 days.
That's when Hazel's heart rate dropped. Doctors performed an emergency C-section. For Nikki and Corey, the hope was they'd be able to hold their little girl, if only for a minute.
The nurse standing behind me taps me on the shoulder and says, now she probably won't cry because she's too early and too small. And the second the doctor got her out and had her in his hands, she goes, "Wah," and let out one tiny cry. At that moment, I knew two things. One, she was going to make it. And two, we were in trouble because she was an opinionated little girl.
Oh, I see those pretty eyes.
Day one, May 9th, 2023.
So they were just, you know, kind of preparing us that she's here, but we don't know how long she's going to be here.
Realistically, it is very hard for babies like that to survive.
But Hazel had her own reality. Dr. Joselle Doyle was part of her NICU care team at Topeka's Stormont Vale.
From the time I met Hazel from delivery, she's always been a fighter. All of her complications, she's always been a fighter.
Day 32 was a good day. They held Hazel for the first time, went to dinner to celebrate. The next morning, they got a call to rush to the hospital. Hazel had stopped breathing.
We got in there and they were doing compressions on her, and her stomach had started to extend, and we didn't know why.
Hazel had a blockage in her intestines. If it perforated and surgeons didn't immediately act, Hazel could die. And those surgeons weren't at Stormont. They were an hour away at their partner, Children's Mercy in Kansas City. A week later, doctors gave the green light. Hazel was stable enough to make the flight.
And she perforated as they landed.
If Children's, if we did not have this partnership with Children's, being able to get Hazel out in such a timely manner, then the outcomes could have been a lot worse.
Hazel would undergo 7 surgeries over the next few months. They lost count of how often her oxygen dropped dangerously low.
They kept telling us, you know, like, this challenge is going to come up and we don't think she's going to make it. And every time she was just like, no, I'm here and I'm going to stay.
It was so up and down from day to day, and it really kind of highlighted the need to take everything one step at a time and, you know, enjoy the good moments so that you don't highlight the bad moments.
There was Halloween, Christmas,
my jersey, go Chiefs,
the Super Bowl, first walk outside, first birthday, then day 378. Finally, Hazel came home.
Actually being in the same house together and being a whole family for the first time in a year, it was relief is the only way I can describe it.
Also, they admit, a bit terrifying. Their new normal includes monitors. Hazel uses a trach, oxygen, and a feeding tube. They have home nursing care, and they helped their other child, Elton John, adjust too.
The second that Hazel came in, he immediately went into the big brother role and started kind of guarding her and, you know, keeping tabs on people.
Corey and Nikki say they can't express thanks enough for every doctor, nurse, friend, and stranger who offered support.
It definitely highlighted the importance of having a good core of people around you and a good community and a good partner.
As for the future, doctors say Hazel's lungs and organs incredibly all look normal. By her second birthday, they say she could be off the oxygen and eating normally. All she needs is time to catch up.
She is the ultimate miracle baby. She is what we call a true survivor. And for me, it's always being reminded what's impossible with man is always possible with God. She literally defied all of the odds.
And Nikki and Corey have no doubt their small but fierce fighter will continue to beat the odds and inspire everyone around her.
But it just puts life into perspective. If this little baby is going to fight so hard to be here, then we're going to fight just as hard for her, you know. That's what I've learned from her. It's just to never give up.
There's always hope. There's always something to believe in.
Melissa Bruner, 13 News.
Beautiful girl. What a fighter she is. From that 13 ounces we mentioned there, Hazel now weighs 18 pounds. She will start therapy in a couple of weeks to help her build strength to start sitting up and standing and eventually walking and running. We wish her all the best and her family too.